working so hard. I'm punching my card. 8 hours for what? Oh, tell me what I got.
Been working so hard. I'm punching my card. 8 hours for what?
For what?
For what?
For what?
For what?
Been working too damn hard. I'm punching that same card. 8 hours busting my butt.
I'm leaving you clowns for the wide open spaces. Hey, people have heard of it. You can find it on any map. People are flocking there from all over.
What's the name of it?
Beaumont.
Beaumont? Where the hell is Beaumont?
I'm playing so cool.
Seat is full. I can't even close the trunk.
Ren, don't start. I don't want to move any more than you.
Then let's not go.
Look, I too wish your father hadn't left, and I too wish things could be the way they were.
Okay, okay.
And we both wish I could be one of those strong, single mothers who suddenly become self-sufficient, but I'm not. Please feel free to disagree.
Mom, we've got a 10-hour drive ahead of us. We've got a lot of time to disagree.
First they have to turn you around, then put your feet on the ground. Now take a hold of your soul.
On any Sunday here we'll be praising our voices in harmony. One day once our trials have ceased, on any Sunday, Lord, I pray, tell me exactly the words to say. Give me strength and maybe then I can reach my fellow men. So we all may rise again. Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Welcome to Beaumont. Good morning. I
I took the long way to church this morning down past the old creek. I heard the birds chirping and our own choir warming up in the distance. I was reminded of a line from a great poet, Walt Whitman, who wrote, I hear America singing. And I thought, are we the song that we sing? Don't we lift our voices to tell the world who we are and what we believe? So I asked you this morning, what song are you singing?
We've only been here 2 days and already Chicago seems a million miles away. But we were barely hanging on, especially with my father gone. There's not too many places we could stay. But maybe mom could find a job that's steady, and maybe I could stand it for a year. And maybe things won't be so bad, and maybe I won't miss my dad, and maybe we can start a new life here.
But if all women were alive today, what song would he hear America singing? When I turn on television, all I hear is the music of easy sexuality and relaxed morals. I hear rock and roll and the endless chat of pornography. And I ask myself, why does our Lord allow this? We know that God has the power to turn all these records and books into one big fierce cinder like that. But he doesn't. And why? Because God is testing us. He wants to see whether we'll choose his path. And that is why every day we must ask ourselves, have I done the right thing?
Have I done the right thing? Picking up my life, packing up the past. That's always frightening.
Have I done the right thing?
This morning, we welcome to our parish two new souls just arrived from Chicago, Ethel McCormick and her son, Ron, is it?
Ren.
Huh? Speak up, let the Lord hear your voice.
Ren.
Ren.
Ren. Interesting name. Is it short for something?
Nope.
Now I invite you to join my wife, Bai, and her daughter, Ariel, to this morning's convocation.
God is love, follow him and never roam. He has made the stars light your way back.
Well, Mrs. McCormick, your sister has certainly been excited about your moving in with them.
Lulu and Wes have been my rock.
I'm in no trouble. Ethel just moved right to the guest room.
And Ren, where'd your uncle put you?
You remember our old tool shop over the garage, right?
Wes, that place is a greasy dump.
Well, no more.
Picture this. Powdered blue wallpaper. Chocolate brown carpet.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
When will Mr. McCormick be joining us?
Mr. McCormick won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separated.
He ran off to find himself.
Ren, please.
Bye, bye. Make some of my toll house cookies. Lulu, try one. You'll burn every recipe in your entire kitchen.
Won't you join us, Mrs. McCormick? Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Call me Ethel, please.
Only if you call me Vi.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
Please behave.
So, Ren, outside for school tomorrow?
We took care of that last week. Both here, you're registered. Hey, Reverend, did you hear that new English teacher is planning to introduce some vulgar modern novel into American Lit course?
Slaughterhouse-Five? Yes, Coach, I've received several calls.
Slaughterhouse-Five? Cool book, cover to cover. That's one bitchin' story. Slaughterhouse-Five, right? Yeah, it's a classic.
Do you read much?
Daddy, excuse me. Rusty and the girls are going out for burgers tonight. Can I?
Tomorrow is a school day.
But Daddy...
Ask your mother.
We already did Reverend Moore, and she said it was okay with her if it's okay with you, so is it okay with you?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. Great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
And oh, what you said about Walt Whitman and rock and roll and listen to the music in your soul. I mean, I was like, who knew?
High praise indeed. Gentlemen?
I, on the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up.
Well then, Ariel, why don't you just talk to him?
Why?
I mean, at least if you talk to him, he'll...
He never listens to me. Welcome to Beaumont.
Howdy.
Oh, you're cute. Oh, isn't he cute, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
And I bet he knows he's cute too, huh, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
Wow,
you want some of this?
Hey, put your tongues back in your mouth and let's get out of here. Come on, Ariel.
See ya.
What?
Where are you going?
And where do you think? And if the question ever comes up, I was with you guys all evening, right?
Are you asking us to lie for you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Hey, good looking. You miss me?
You wish.
Hey there, Ariel.
How's it going?
Hey, Travis, Lyle. Oh my God, did I interrupt your weekly poetry club meeting?
Very funny. So, who's that new guy in church?
Who? Oh, him. He's our new classmate. A Chicago transplant with all the charm and sophistication that comes from living in a bustling metropolis.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Hey, Creston, just what are you doing with the preacher's daughter?
Anything that I want.
Oh, yeah? And what does she get out of it?
Everything that she needs.
Like you know.
Was she like you think she was born yesterday? With her innocent looks and her little town way. When she's smiling at me, she's got angels in her eyes. But I've seen how she moves and this girl really cooks. She taught me some tricks you can't learn in books. And I'm starting to think she's the devil in disguise. The girl gets around. She knows what she likes.
Huh.
I've got what she needs. Just wait till tonight. We'll both make our moves. Yeah, we come so round. The girl gets around, 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 around. Good God, this girl gets around.
Ariel, I swear, God's gonna strike you down like.
No, she's not.
She's not?
Excellent!
Yeah, he likes to pretend he's a man among men. But with his hands in his pockets, he can't count to 10. Don't worry, baby, your secret's safe with me.
Busted!
And he bores me to tears with his fears and his fight. But I keep him around, cause when temptation strikes,
what she needs.
Yeah.
Just wait till tonight.
Maybe tonight.
Wait till tonight. I'll make her move. Yeah, I'll be coming so around. The girl gets around.
Reverend, I went to the burger box. Your friend suggested I might find you here.
We were just on our way.
Your mother thought you might be cold.
Evening, Reverend! The girl gets around! She knows what she likes! I got what she needs! Just wait till tonight. A girl gets around, 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 around. Good God, this girl gets around.
Hey, Ariel, right?
Yeah, so?
I'm Ren. Ren McCormick, we met after church. Is this a small world or what? I'm your new classmate.
Howdy.
Girl, leave that poor boy alone.
That's a good one.
Hey, mister. You bummed me.
Sorry.
Don't you ever watch where you're going?
I said I was sorry.
Hey, you're that new kid from Chicago, ain't you?
Perhaps.
Smart ass, huh? Listen, you fella. Around here, push your money, they push back. Next thing you know, you got two people pushing. Get it?
Got it. Let me ask you something. This old men's clothes where you got that hat?
What is that, some kind of stupid joke?
Oh, it's a really good joke.
That's it, man, I'm gonna kill you!
Please kill me.
Huh?
Kill me! That's the most exciting thing I've heard since I've hit town! Ren McCormick, and you are?
Willard. Willard Hewitt.
Willard, what do you do around here for a good time? Yeah, besides that, you got any clubs?
Nope.
What about movies?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope.
What about...
Nope. We do have a Bolorama down by the interstate.
Wow, I really admire you. I can never do what you guys do around here.
Oh yeah? What do we do?
Nothing. I never walk when I could run. I don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should. Kick back and chill. I can't stand still.
I can see that.
I called the doctor. He said, son, I cannot offer you a pill. So I never found relief. And now I've got to move until I've had my fill. I can't stand still. Back where I come from, life's never humdrum. I wish I could take you there. Oh, we had the world at our feet. Life was sweet, ain't no doubt. Grab a seat, check it out.
You're gonna last about 5 minutes in this town.
I thought it never would end, but I lost it somehow. Would you look at me now? I'm trying hard to tone it down. Gotta watch my P's and Q's. Maybe look before I leap. But then I think, hey, what's the use? Ain't done it yet. I can't forget how it feels when you dance till you drop. So don't even start to suggest that I stop. I never will. No. Then please kill me, cause I can't stand still. No, no,
no, no, no, no, no!
No!
Ya man!
What are you doing?
Oh, just telling Willard here about Chicago, you know. Chicago! That's odd, Lindsay.
Look like that.
Oh, that! I was just showing him a couple of steps, you know, stuff he used to do.
No, don't! Don't!
Don't what? Oh, you mean this?
Ren McCormick!
Oh, shit!
There is no dancing allowed here!
What?
Listen to the man!
Oh, I get it. School property, not supposed to have any fun.
Now, that may pass for wit in Chicago, but we try to speak simply here. So let me make this as clear as I can. There will be no dancing of any kind, at any time, anywhere within the city limits of Beaumont.
But what?
Ever!
No, seriously. He's joking, right? I get it, ha ha. Joke's on the new kid.
Mr. Hewitt, would you please inform your friend?
It's against the law.
Dancing? Get out!
Shut up. Mr. Clark, sir, Ren is very sorry. He was very ignorant of our local law, and I will inform him of his ignorance.
And you will both be in my office after school. I think you people have someplace to be.
Oh my gosh, Willard, the way you spoke to Principal Clark, that was like the longest sentence ever made. Chin up, Mr. McCormick. You know, it's such a turn on watching a guy fly in the face of authority.
Was he serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is against the law?
Has been for 5.5 years, ever since that accident.
What accident?
The Batani Bridge accident? You've never heard of the Batani Bridge accident?
If I had, would I be doing this?
Oh my god. Ladies, should I take this one?
Please.
Be my guest. There were these four kids we all grew up with, and they were coming home from a big dance over in Baylor County. Now, I don't know if it was the rain, or maybe they were being a little wild, but somehow they lost control of the car, skidded across the bridge, crashed through the railing, and fell 35 feet into the Batani River.
Did anyone survive? Oh.
Yeah. And the autopsy report claimed there was alcohol and marijuana in their blood. Everyone in this town went nuts.
And that's when Reverend Moore got so righteous. He started blaming anything and everything. Drugs, alcohol, rock and roll.
And dancing.
You got it.
Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power. He is the law.
How can you stand to live like this?
Practice, years of practice.
It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to just be like walking down the street and then you get mugged by someone you don't even know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I miss that. I thought that living in a small town was gonna be perfect, like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move.
There's fingers pointing every time you turn around.
There's head shaking the minute you cross the line. And there's eyes everywhere.
Careful what you do, someone's on to you. Careful what you do. Careful what you say, 'cause you're on display every night and every day. Somebody's waiting in the great unknown. And every time you think that you're alone, ha! Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are seeing you come and go. Somebody's out there waiting for the show. You've got no disguise from somebody's eyes.
Look, thanks for the advice, but it's not gonna get to me.
Gets to everybody.
You don't know me.
You don't know Beaumont. Somebody's eyes. Whoa. Somebody's eyes. Whoa!
Choreographed!
learned that a Beaumont stop sign means stop.
I thought I did.
And that radio music of yours is blasting really loud.
Oh, so you pulled me over because my music's too loud?
Hey, watch your attitude, boy.
Book him, Jim.
Is this a friend of yours,
Chuck? City kid. I want to let him kiss my ass.
They seem nice.
Careful. Careful how you speak. Turn the other cheek. Be careful how you speak. Think a naughty thought. And if you get caught, well, then boy, you've got a lot of trouble. Somewhere there's someone with the perfect view. You! And they're just dying for a little peek-a-boo. Boo! Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes will never close, never sleep. Somebody's after the secrets that you keep. Alibis from somebody's eyes.
This boy turned my wrestling practice into a brawl.
Yeah!
Yeah!
I don't want to expose my nose, just slammed into your fist.
Yes, Donald! Oh, that's enough! My boys know the difference between a wrestling match and a street fight.
Oh, really, coach? A wrestling match is usually one-on-one.
Hey, that's enough out of you. Do you realize that this is the third time in as many weeks that somebody's called you into my office? I've decided you're off the wrestling team indefinitely.
Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes. Whoa! Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes. Whoa!
Do you know how hard it was for me to get a job in Amherst Harbor Store? Because I went a month and you get fired.
Lulu, exaggerate.
Hush, you are not helping things.
Ren, what did happen?
Nothing I should have been fired for. Willard came by the store asking for change for a dollar. So I popped open the register, and when Mr. Dillingham saw my hand in the drawer, he went crazy. He accused me of stealing.
Are you on drugs?
No! Why don't you just frisk me? You probably poked everything in my room.
Ren, apologize to your uncle.
Look, young man, I'm not your father.
And you can say that again.
Wes!
Don't say anything, Ethel.
I cannot not say anything, Wes. I don't know how to do that.
Pumpkin, hush, please.
Yes, I do realize we are guests in your home.
Ethel, just don't say anything.
Never walk too loud. Never leave a crowd. Never drip risque. There'll be hell to pay. If you've ever had anything to hide, think twice before you step outside. Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are following every move. Somebody's waiting to show they don't approve. Nothing satisfies somebody's eyes.
Ain't no alibis
in somebody's eyes.
You don't want us, guys.
From somebody's eyes. Somebody's eyes. Whoa!
Chuck, stop. I don't want to be late.
What's a few more minutes?
Whoa! My dad is somehow crazy about me seeing you.
Well, tell him to get used to it.
You tell him.
I will.
Maybe not right now. I'm not in the mood for one of his sermons. Bye now. Go home.
Whoa! Hi, Daddy. Mom.
Are you hungry?
I'm starving. What's this?
Wait,
don't tell me. Haydn, the second sonata?
The fourth.
Oh, number four, right. I guess that kind of music's okay, huh, Daddy?
Meaning?
She's just making a joke, Shaw.
I'm aware of that, Bai. This kind of music is uplifting. It doesn't confuse the mind.
Are you working on your sermon?
I am.
Remember when I was a kid? On Saturdays, I would sit in a pew down front and listen to you practice
over and over?
I do indeed.
And then I would clap, and you would bow, remember?
Well, you seem to have outgrown that.
Shaw?
What just happened? Did I say something wrong?
Your father's had a difficult day.
Vi, I can speak for myself.
Honey, why don't you go set the table?
I'm not very hungry.
Shaw, if you're angry with Ariel, please tell her why.
I'm not angry. I'm concerned.
Then get to the point. You two speak and nothing gets said.
Have you seen her with this Chuck Cranston? The last time I walked in are the two of them.
You told me.
The boy has a record of arrests, Vi.
And the more you object, the more intrigued she is going to be.
So I should just hold my peace?
I do. And I pray that her infatuation with Chuck Cranston lasts no longer than mine with Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell was not an overheated delinquent.
He most certainly was.
This is not funny.
Just trying to lighten the mood.
Well, I can't. I'm fine about where Ariel is and what she's doing.
You can't expect her to sit home with us.
Let's just stop this conversation right now.
Conversation?
Bye.
I seem to have walked in on one of your sermons.
Please, let's not say anything we might regret.
Swallowing my words, staring at the floor, counting little cracks in the tar, struggling to smile without choking, learning to be silent.
Watching how the dust dances out the door, noticing my hands start to shake, contemplating taking up smoking, learning to be silent.
Always hearing,
hush, Ethel.
Please, Vi, let's not have this conversation.
And so I stand by while my mind takes a small vacation. La 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 la.
Making little sounds other folks ignore,
quieting the beat of my heart, never being part of the moment,
learning to be silent,
learning there are some topics that we don't even mention,
and if they come up then we try to be vague.
There are subjects from which we divert all attention,
and some we avoid like the plague.
Becoming a man,
biting my tongue,
biting my tongue,
trying not to scream.
Managed it before,
knowing if I'm going to survive. And damn it,
I've got to practice.
Ariel, this book report you wrote is so great.
almost wish I read the book.
Hurry up, Rusty. I have to copy it next.
How do you pronounce this word?
Camelot.
Really?
Really.
You know what part sounds great?
I like the part when King Arthur and Lancelot fight over Guinevere. It's right after Mordred shows up and says, I'm the king, I'm the king.
What?
You read a book? Cliff Notes took me forever.
It's even better in the book. There's all these knights on horseback jousting and storming the castle.
All we get are guys in overalls and pickup trucks.
I'm wearing overalls.
I'm sorry.
Hi, Willard.
Hi. How are you all doing?
You know,
I'm okay.
Hey, Rusty.
Hey, Willard.
Well, see ya.
Oh, hi, Willard.
That's it? You two are pathetic.
When are you two going to have a real conversation?
Willard's not capable of a real conversation. I kind of like that in a guy.
What the? Hey, Ren, how's the new job?
Well, it's my second day and I haven't been fired yet.
You may have found your future.
I may have. What can I get you?
Diet Coke, please.
Diet Coke. I'll have the Hula Burger that had cheese melt with extra mayo on side fries. Oh, and a Diet Coke.
And Ariel, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
Oh my gosh! Did you really just say that?
It chucks easy fun with all you are, damn man!
She usually doesn't even remember me.
Well, that uniform makes you look like such an asshole. It's easier to pick you out.
Willard, you are always looking for a fight, aren't you?
My mama says it's my nature.
Shut up. Tell me what you know about Ariel.
Well, I heard she's been kissed a lot.
And?
And she's onto you like a hog on slop!
Get out of here!
Ariel likes trouble, and you have definitely proved to everybody in this town that you are T-R-U-B-L.
Come on, I was only teasing him.
That's more than teasing. Ren's from out of town, and don't tell me that doesn't curl your toes.
You want Al Beaumont so bad, you memorize bus schedules. Mm-hmm.
You told us you read just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly! In books, I get to meet guys who amaze me.
What about Ren?
What about him?
He's sort of smart.
He's kind of tall.
Oh, and I think he's handsome.
Cute. Maybe. But can he really compare to Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout who was recently a victim in Trailer Park? I don't think so. Thank you.
So Willard, what's the deal with you and Rusty?
Oh, beats me. I think she's good looking and all, but I never know what the hell she's talking about. She talks faster than any girl I ever met.
Because you make it horny.
You think?
If only I could find a guy who'd make the first move.
If only I could find a guy who, when he went to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth.
Ew.
If only I could find a guy. Where have all the good men gone? And where are all the gods?
Yeah.
Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising odds?
I'd like to know. Someone reaching back for me. Do, 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 do.
I need a hero. I'm cold enough for a hero till the end.
sure, and he's gotta be soon, and he's gotta be larger than life.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
And why would you? You do such a good job of it yourself.
Shut up, Rusty. Excuse me. Will you be joining these ladies for dinner? When I say me to eight, what am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right. Calm down, honey.
Tell me to calm down. Don't ever tell me what to do. Listen, I know what your friends think of me. And that's bullshit. I'm the best party in this town, baby.
What the?
And those three dogs ought to be tied up under a porch. Let's go.
No.
Get in the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no. Well, part of that, don't you understand?
Oh, when the preacher's daughter says no, it just makes me hot. Say it
Chuck,
again, baby.
Stop.
Excuse me, I believe the lady said no. And I believe this is none of your business. I don't think we've ever been formally introduced. Ren McCormick. Get your hand out of my face and get your face out of my sight.
Hey, Chuck, looking for a fight? Hey, let's party!
Willard, oh, don't lose me.
Oh, man, let me nail him. I'll nail him.
Oh, my God.
Hey, do we not call him here?
No, ma'am. Me and the guys were just discussing the comfort and safety of one of your valued customers.
I think that's funny.
Your pickup truck is parked in the handicap zone only, which is a place for people with physical, not emotional, disabilities.
You haven't seen the last of me, McCormick.
Can I please kick his ass?
Willard, what's that your mama always says? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your five.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, this is not your five. Now, don't the rest of you have curfew?
I know, ma'am. I'll turn in my apron.
Listen to me. I'll see you here after school tomorrow.
So I'm not fired?
No. Now give me a hug, honey. Thank you.
You're either very brave or very stupid.
Which do you think?
I haven't made up my mind yet. Want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Ooh, you're right! Please, my daddy invented it. But don't you think rules are made to be broken? Come on!
Wait, where are we going?
You'll see.
Thank you.
answering the train. I'm saying I can't wait for the day when I get on board and leave Beaumont. Try it.
No, thanks. I just ate. You know, you really are something.
What do you mean?
I mean, the whole package. Minister's kid, Chuck Cranston's girlfriend.
Guilty.
Just a church-going gal with some badass red cowboy boots.
My daddy hates me wearing these boots.
You love that, don't you? Getting up in his face.
Yeah, that way he'll notice when I'm gone.
Where are you gonna go?
College, for starters. I've already applied to some places my daddy doesn't even know about. I want to speak 5 languages and see the world. He wants me to teach English lit in Baylor County. They don't even speak English in Baylor County.
I can't picture you as a teacher.
Thanks. Neither can I. I'll leave that to my daddy.
He's a preacher, not a teacher.
When you're good at it, it's the same thing. And he used to be real good.
What changed?
His mind. He closed it.
I noticed.
He used to be so open, so inspiring. I've seen him give people hope when hope was gone. I've watched him change lives.
Well, if you love him so much, why do you want to tick him off so bad?
I didn't say I loved him.
Boy, do I know what you mean. My dad.
What happened there?
One day he just walked out the door. No goodbye, nothing.
I bet you've got lots to say to him.
Lots.
Tell it to the train. I do.
How can you be so stupid and involving me? I hate you!
Feel better?
Not sure yet.
Do you want to kiss me?
Someday.
Someday? What do you mean, someday?
I just have a feeling you've been kissed a lot and I'd suffer by comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you?
Oh, I think more of you more than I expected. Come on, I'll walk you home.
Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes are following every move. Somebody's waiting to show they don't approve.
Okay, let's see. Harry, you owe Eleanor
75 cents, and Reverend, you owe me $1.25.
Eleanor, why does it seem like the only place my parents seem to fail me is at the bridge table?
Come on, do I have one, please? Hi, y'all know Ren McCormick. Daddy, Ren?
Reverend Moore! Hey, Principal Clark, how's it going? Coach Dunbar?
Hi, Mrs. Dunbar.
Miss Moore.
Welcome, Ren.
Hey, poker night. Cool.
Ariel, all this time we thought you were upstairs in your room. Doing your homework.
It's hard to impose a curfew on the people of my congregation when I can't seem to impose one in my own home. What's that old saying? It's the shoemaker's children who always go barefoot.
Oh, would you look at the time?
Here you go. Boy, I sure can clear a room.
It's a rare talent.
I'm gonna take that as a compliment.
I can assure you it was not meant that way.
Floop! Ah! I believe this is yours.
Ren, thanks for, you know.
Walking you home?
Yeah, that too.
Well, this was fun, Reverend, don't you think?
Somebody's eyes are seeing you come and go.
Boy, I sure blew it in there, didn't I?
Yeah, you did.
I get nervous, I go crazy, I end up putting my own foot in my mouth.
Your mother says you're good at it, but I had no idea.
Good night, Miss Moore.
Good night.
Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes.
Whoa! I'm gonna punch out somebody, 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 somebody's eyes.
Whoa!
I don't want you to see him again.
Run? Why? Just because he hasn't lived in this town his whole life?
That's not it, but clearly the boy has no respect for authority.
Who's everyone? The Bridge Club? Come on, give me a break.
Ariel, what am I gonna do with you?
Me, Daddy? Lately all you do is look for the worst in people. And then, of course, you find
Hi, him. My, where did that come from?
From you, Daddy. Today's sermon is, the world is evil. And Ariel has to be locked away in tower.
That's a little melodramatic, don't you think?
No, I don't. You make me feel like a prisoner. And I hate it! I just hate it.
Someone's got to put a foot down.
I didn't say anything.
I don't enjoy being her jailer. I don't relish telling her no. But then I think, what if I fail her? How can I just let her go? I strive to be a good preacher. I strive not to go overboard. But then I think, if I can reach her, how can I face my Lord? Heaven help me shoulder my load. Every day's a struggle still. Someone's got to take the high road. If I don't, who will? I became a man of God to do his work, to spread his word, to ease some pain and dry some tears. That was the plan. But I might have thought twice if only I knew that I'd spend all of my time saying, no, no, don't do that. See, everyone prays for salvation. I'm happy to give them the tools. The problem is, here's my frustration. Nobody wants to have rules. So heaven help me with my labors. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors? Heaven help me. Oh, heaven help me. If heaven can, who can?
You and your friends are late.
Coach, Ren is hurt.
Look at his hand. He's all banged up.
It's nothing. It was just...
Please don't waste your breath or my time with another lame excuse.
It's not an excuse. After Ren walked me home last night, some guys jumped him.
They just started wailing on him. There was like six of them.
Willard, it was three guys.
Anybody you know?
Well, I didn't get names, if that's what you mean.
Well, it seems when you're not making trouble, it finds you anyways. And Ariel, I would encourage you to stay away from him. I've been asking my eye on you.
Oh, my father called you. Surprise, surprise.
And if you cooperate, make our lives much easier.
Gee, if my daddy makes a phone call, would you get off of my back?
That mouth of yours calling me your daddy walk out in the first place.
Count to 10, man! Mama says she's count to 10!
You wise to take your friend's advice. Now drop down and give me 30.
You're joking.
You're right, make it 50.
He's not joking, Coach. He really is hurting.
Thank you for your diagnosis, Dr. Willard. You can give me 50 as well. As a matter of fact, all of you give me 50. Just do it! One! Two!
3.
Four.
Only 5. 6.
Is he gone?
7. 8. I'm sorry, it's just this whole town's so wound up. Hey, man. Like, you don't have any place to blow off any steam. At least in Chicago, you could go to the clubs.
Hey, maybe I'll take the coach dancing.
Willard, you are so...
What? What are you thinking?
That's it.
What?
We are gonna throw a dance. We are gonna throw a kick-ass party that knocks Beaumont right off its tractor.
You're just asking for a fight.
Bring it on.
Are you ready to take on Reverend
Moore? I'll take on anybody.
What about the town council?
Come fight City Hall. If there's one thing worth fighting for, it's freedom. Looking into your eyes, I know I'm right. If there's anything worth the fear, it's worth the fight. No one can tie my hands or make me change my plans. I'm crossing the line, jumping the track, taking what's mine and not looking back. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. Every day I face a new frontier. I can't worry what the world will say. I may fly or fall, but either way, I'm free!
Ren, you're not free, you're crazy! You know there's a law.
Maybe that's a law that needs changing.
Hello, Beaumont's never gonna let us forget the Patani Bridge accident.
How long are you gonna live in that shadow? There's gotta be a way out of this.
No. And the only way out of this is by train.
No, listen.
Running away will never make you free. Doesn't matter where you go, I guarantee. Long as we hold our ground, we cannot be bound. We're shaking the past, making our breaks, taking control if that's what it takes. Heaven helps the man who fights his fear. We can face this down right now, right here. Once you're standing on your own two feet, you will not retreat if you repeat.
I'm free! Come on, try it!
I'm free!
Let the Lord hear your voices!
I'm free!
Yeah!
We're shaking the past, making our breaks, taking control, and that's what it takes.
I'm free!
His fear. We can raise this down right now, right here. Maybe we can finally right this wrong. Arm in arm and side by side, we're strong
and free. Now word comes to me that some young people in our community wants to change the law and throw a dance. This morning, let's remind ourselves that this law is not about dancing. This law is a tribute to four young people who held the promise of Beaumont's brightest future.
Heaven helps the man.
And we stand united in honoring their memory.
We can face this down.
You will see
heaven help me, son.